Welcome back, students. This is the third video of this week, and today we are going to continue our chapter 4, that is clothes we wear. In the previous video, we came to know the process by which the raw material are converting into the clothes, and this video we are going to know more about the clothes, that means why we are using the different type of clothes in the different season, what is the reason behind choosing the different fiber in the different season, and next about the uniforms, what are the need of the uniform and why the different profession are having the different type of uniform. Okay, so let's start knowing about all these things. In the summer days, we used to wear the clothes that are light in color and also they are not very heavy, and mostly they are made up of the cotton, linen or khadi clothes, that means nature friendly. Okay, why we are using these type of clothes? And in the winter season we are using the woolen clothes. What is the reason behind choosing the woolen clothes? Here I am going to discuss. These are made from the woolen fiber, okay, which are having the features to keep our body warm. Now let's know how these woolen clothes keep our body warm. When we are wearing the warm clothes like sweater, mufflers, jackets, gloves, socks and the trousers, okay, they don't allow our body heat to escape from these clothes. These clothes are not having any pores and they are having the capability to stop the heat within the clothes. Whatever body heat we are having, these clothes does not allow to escape into the environment, and by that way the wind is not passing from the environment to our body, and our body heat is also not going out from these woolen clothes, and by that process our body remain warm all the time when we are wearing these woolen clothes. Now next, we choose to wear the waterproof material in the rainy season. That is going on recently. This is the monsoon season. Okay, and we are wearing the raincoat, gloves, gum boots, umbrellas, and hat. Why we are using these material? Because these are waterproof. And how these waterproof material protect us from getting wet, we will discuss in this video only, but later on. Before that, let's know why we are choosing the light color in the summer season whereas the dark color in the winter season. Mostly we used to wear the light color. What is the meaning of light color? Like white color or sky blue, light pink, okay, whatever light shade is available in the market, we used to wear that clothes. Whereas in the winter season we used to wear the dark color, like dark blue color, black color, brown color. Okay, why? What is the concept behind that? Let's know. As you can see, there are two t-shirts present here. You are able to see one black t-shirt is there and one arrow is showing towards the black t-shirt. What it is indicating? It is indicating that the heat from the sun is getting absorbed by the black color, whereas one reflecting arrow is shown in the white color. That means white color used to reflect the light or reflect the heat from the sun, and they don't absorb much heat from the sun. This is the reason why we used to choose the different color in the different season. Okay, black color or the dark color are having capability to absorb. They absorb more heat, and if we are wearing the dark color, we will feel also hot. And if we are using the white color or any light shade, then those color reflect the heat, and by that way we keep our body cool in the summer season. And this is the reason why we use the light color in the summer whereas the dark color in the winter season. Let's know more about the clothes. In the summer season, we are wearing the linen clothes or the cotton clothes. Why? Because these type of clothes are more comfortable. What happened actually, if they are absorbing the sweat, because in the summer season we sweat a lot, and whatever sweat has produced in our body, they all get absorbed by these clothes, and these clothes passes the absorbed heat to the environment by the process of evaporation. Let me show, my dear. As you can see, these are the sweat, okay, which is producing in our body, and when these are getting absorbed by these cotton clothes are sending them to the environment, okay, and these are getting evaporated when absorbing the heat, and by this way these sweat are getting into the environment, okay, and by this process we are keeping our body cool, because sweat has been absorbed by the cotton clothes, and cotton clothes are converting that sweat into the evaporation, and by that process these clothes help us to keep our body cool in the summer season. Okay, this is the reason why your mother forced you to wear the cotton clothes in the summer season. Next, this is the material which we are using in the rainy season. Okay, let me show you. This is the raincoat. Okay, this is the raincoat, as you can see, and you are able to see the water droplets on the surface of this material also. Why? Because these waterproof material does not allow the water to pass through that. If we are wearing the raincoat in the rainy season, all the water is falling and on that waterproof material, and they are repelling, or they are not allowing the water droplets to go inside that fabric, and by that way we do not get wet in the rainy season. Okay, our clothes does not get wet. We are not getting wet by wearing this. Okay, why? Because these fabrics does not allow water to pass through that. Okay, now let's know about the uniform. Remember something, nowadays you are not coming to the school, but remember when you used to come to the school, you used to wear the uniform like these children. Recognize them, these are the doctors, okay, and they also have the different uniform. Okay, every doctor is having the different uniform depending on the hospital, but one common thing, that is the white apron or white coat, they always used to wear. Why? So that they can easily recognize that they are the doctor. If you are going to the hospital, then how you will know who is the doctor, who is the patient? Because by the stethoscope and by the white coat only. If someone is wearing the white coat and has taken the stethoscope, then we recognize them that he is the doctor. Next, this is the black coat wearing. This is the black coat which has been worn by the human being, and this is the lawyer. Okay, lawyer used to wear the black coat, and by that way we recognize them. They used to wear the white shirt and white pant inside that, but our the black blazer or the black coat is very very compulsory. Okay, next, this is the uniform of the soldier. Our soldier is having these type of uniform, and the design what you are seeing, or okay, the print what you are seeing, these print are important so that first of all they can be recognized, or these are creating sometime confusion, and so that the enemies cannot recognize them. Suppose they are hiding in the forest, so these create the camouflage. Okay, camouflage means from far distance they cannot be recognized by the animal by the animals and by the enemies also. Okay, and they can protect themselves. This is the reason behind choosing this color. So this is the uniform of the soldier, and this is the uniform of the different type of workers who is working in the factory, or who is working on the site, who are involved in the building processes or the manufacturing processes, they used to wear the different type of clothes. Okay, why? So that they cannot get dirty. Their clothes, what they are using inside, that will not get dirty. Okay. Now let's resemble all these points together. Uniforms. Why the uniforms are important? First of all, uniforms are important to be identified by the other people. Suppose you are going to the zoo. Sometime you are going outside of your school, then how your teachers will recognize who are my children from the far? If I am seeing close to you, then I can easily recognize you. But suppose you are at the far distance, then how could I recognize you whether you are my student or not? Okay, so this is the very important, so that every person can recognize who they are. Second, some uniforms like the uniform of the workers and the doctor are used to prevent their clothes from becoming dirty. Okay, they are using coat so that the inside what they are wearing, okay, that will not get wet, and by this process they can protect their clothes and maintain the cleanliness also. Okay, so this is why the uniforms important. And one more thing is there, uniforms are important to create the similarity between all the person. Suppose you are little rich and someone is little poor, then in the school you could not recognize who is poor or who is rich, because all are same and all are wearing the same uniform, and in the front of the teachers all students are same. That's why you are given a particular uniform. Okay, and every profession has been given a particular uniform for them. Thank you so much for watching. I hope this will be helpful for you.